Hello, and welcome to a new EasyDigitals.com video tutorial. Remember, you can get all of our high-quality Photoshop and Photoshop Elements templates at EasyDigitals.com. Just click on the Products button. And don't forget to sign up for our monthly newsletter. We give away free templates and tutorials each and every month, along with product update info and coupons. Okay, Kim, what easy tutorial are you going to show us today?
Okay, so now I get to add some text. I'm going to go to my text tool. I'm just going to come down here, type in my name. Come over to Window, Character, all caps is on. So you can just float over these if you want to know the name of them. And it says it's all caps. So if I turn that off, highlight it and turn it off, you can see that it was, the way I typed it out was the first letter was capitalized and the on each. But I do want this in all caps, so I'm just going to go ahead and turn that back on. And the font I want to use for this is this Bangdang Hardcore. I'm not even sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but this is a free font that you can get at DaFont, and I'll put a link to that in the bottom of this tutorial. I'm going to stretch this out. Press Enter and come over to it and highlight it all. And I'm going to bring this a little bit closer together. And I also want it to be left justified. So I press the left justified button. And I'm just going to arrow this back over with my arrow key. And then I'm going to drag it over. So I've got the name there. I'm going to go ahead and add a slight drop shadow, because in these light areas it gets to where you almost can't see the difference between the two whites, and it makes it hard to read. So when it's hard to read something, the easiest way to correct that is to add some type of drop shadow or stroke. But in this case it would look better with a drop shadow. So I'm going to go ahead and double click, click drop shadow, take it up to 100%. I'm just going to cheat a little bit and see what I used over here on this poster, because I can't remember what my settings were for this one. Drop shadow, 4 and 4 at 100%. And I thought that looked pretty good, so I'm going to come over here and just change this to 4 and this to 4 and click OK. And then place it. We'll move this around in a second. Then I'm going to add his number. So I just grab my type tool, click anywhere, and type the number, which is 81. And I'm going to go ahead. It goes ahead and chooses to do the same font that I used before. So that's good. I don't have to change that. If you want to make sure that these line up exactly, you can bring down a guide. Just drag a guide out of the ruler up here and then down here, and just drag this out. Just drag it out where it hits the guide. Enter. And again, we are losing a little bit here because of the white on white. So, and if you want to copy an exact style, you can just press your Alt key and take the effect and drag it up to the other place that you want to use it. So I'm going to go ahead and scoot this over a little bit. I'm leaving a little bit of a margin on the edge, and if you want to, you can add a guide to show you where to put your margins. Let's just say I added this is like a half inch on this, but which is probably too much. I don't really need to be quite this far in with my type. But it's just a good starting place. And I'm going to press on this 81 and click on Cody Smith while my shift is held down. And it highlights both of them, so both of these layers are highlighted. And then I can resize them together. If I press my shift key, it will keep the aspect ratio. Press Enter. And let's say I decide I want this 81 to be a little bit see-through. I'm going to lower the opacity on this to, I don't know, you can play with it to something that you like. And I'm going to do one more thing. I'm going to add one more bit of text here. This time I'm going to use Arial Black. Click on Arial and come up here, Black. Oop, I changed that one. Hey, that looks kind of cool. But that's not what I want to do, so I'm going to go back. I'm going to click to make a new layer, new text layer. And I'm going to come up here and go to Arial, and then right here, Black. And then I'm going to say whatever I want to say, which this I'm just going to say 2010 Liberty Blue Jays football. Center that. Come to my Move tool. And that just happens to fit, but you may need to resize this. It needs to be resized just a little bit. I'm going to select it all and change it to, actually I'm going to take this to -5. Take this a little bit smaller by just hovering over this and moving to the left. I can make it a little bit smaller. Then I'm going to scoot this over. I'm going to come up here to View, Show, Guides, and turn those off so that I can see what it looks like. And I think I've decided that I want to move everything, all the text down, so I'm just going to select. So I'm going to click on the text, and then press Shift, and click on the third one, and then I'm just going to arrow them all down. Sometimes Photoshop doesn't like to cooperate with me. And then I'm going to come up to File, Save. Okay, stay tuned because I'm going to show you one more thing that you can do with this poster.
Hey, that was easy. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about this tutorial or any of our products, you can always reach us at easydigitals.com. Have a creative day.